So I'm Prisca Flato. I'm the director of the Engineering Center for the Upper Regions. I spent almost 3 years in India. And with my team, we have deployed the BIM processes in our fields. And today, I'm going to speak about infrastructure projects, but the large one, the big scale infrastructure project, and how we use BIM to succeed this kind of project. But first of all, let me introduce Systra. So Systra is a small engineering and consulting group at international scale. When we are talking about high-speed rail lines and metro projects, we have been involved in 50% of them worldwide. So we do not intend to become big and the largest company, but we want to be the signature team for high-speed rail line and metro projects. So what we love is the technical challenge to integrate complex systems in linear civil infrastructures and complex transport network. So you can see here some examples of our realization worldwide. But you will see after that we have done a lot in India in terms of metro lines and design. So we have 6,000 employees in the world. And in India, we have our most important design centers. And I'm really happy to be there today because, you know, I spent 3 years here. And everything is possible in India. We have now reached the BIM level 2 this year. And this is only possible here when you have the dynamisms and the energy to do it. So, when I'm saying that we are working everywhere, you can see on this map that we are working in, I think, all the continents. And we are working for mostly transportation. But you can see that we have some signature team also for tunnels and bridge that we're putting to the service of our clients throughout the world. So let's focus a little bit in Systra. So in Systra India, we have 1,500 people. So it seems that by the end of the year, we'll have more Indian nationals in Systra than French nationals. So we have 4 offices, one in Delhi, one in Ahmedabad, and 2 others in Mumbai and Kolkata. So we are doing PMC and design in India. And today, we are designing or doing the supervision for 9 metro lines, Ahmedabad, Bangalore, Chennai, Mumbai, Kanpur, Nagpur, Pune, Lucknow, and so on. So you can see that we have a huge presence here in India, where we are doing most of the metro line which are designed and built today. So when we are talking about large infrastructure projects, I think that Subiya project is a definition of what is a huge project. This C-Link is the world record in terms of C-Link. And this is 48 kilometers of viaduct, and we were main designer for 36 kilometers. So these 36 kilometers of highways comprises 2 big interchanges. You see the one side Subiya, 2 artificial islands, 1 cable stay, buildings, and all the facilities related to the use and the operation of this project. So we have started this project 4 years back, and 250 engineers work on this project in India, in Korea, in Paris, and we worked all together to deliver these projects. So 4 years back, we did not use BIM to do it. So I think that today, if we will have to restart a project of this scale, we'll never do that without BIM. No questions. No question at all. Definitely, we'll use BIM in order to reduce the time, also the design, to reduce the risk of construction, to deliver a model which can be used by the contractor to deliver their precast segment, as you can see here, and to be more efficient in terms of human resources, in terms of design, and definitely we were doing great before BIM processes, but today we are better with the implementation of the digitalization and the BIM processes in the group. So we have talked about the multi-site. So of course, you can imagine that we have some difficulties to work between Paris, India, Korea, Dubai. So we need to have the tools to collaborate. But we also work on very complex infrastructures. And when we build an infrastructure, it's to support the system of the transportation, the metro, the cable, the power supply, the cable for the telecom, and so on and so far. So we need to have a federated model which allows us to manage all the coordination within the disciplines and also within the group. And the last challenge is we are working each time as a prototype. The metro in Chennai is different from the metro in Dubai, is different from the metro in Ahmedabad, and we need each time to rework on the environment, on the integration, on the interfaces, on the needs of our clients, to be adaptable and agile for our clients. So these challenges are there, and in Systra, we bring some replies to that through innovation, through collaboration, to bring the optimization to our client and to the final users. So today I will present to you BIM in One Click, which is the linear infra tools for BIM developed by Systra, and GeoSystra, which is a GIS platform that we are using for simulation and for geotechnical borehole and so on. Also, one thing about collaboration. So in Systra, we try and we deliver the best services and the same services throughout the world to our clients. And for that, we bring the collaboration to a level where all our engineers specialized in one field are linked together. And if you have an issue on an expertise in India, you can share your problem with an engineer in Dubai or in Korea or in Paris very fast with the collaboration means that we are putting in place. So this is something for us which is very, very important. When everybody is working on the same platform and on the same collaboration, collaborative platform, it's really, really important to have the tools to do that. So that's why also that for us, the cloud and all the CDE that we are putting in place supports our solution, our innovative solution, BIM in One Click and GeoSystra. So I've shown to you Subia, which was a large-scale project done without BIM. So today, I'm very proud to show Bogota Metro First Line. It's a metro which has been designed by Systra for the station. So there are 16 stations. There is 22 building facilities. And we have done more than 200 models. So why we have done that? It was not primarily in the requirement of the client, but we have done that to ease the collaboration between the teams based in France. We have done that also for the adoption of the project, for the stakeholders, the public authorities. We have built that for the end user to understand what we are planning to do for their city. So it was one of the first projects that we have done with BIM processes, and definitely in India and elsewhere, we will not start a metro station without BIM processes today. So let's talk about BIM in one click. So BIM in one click is a tool which is powered by Civil 3D. It's an app, actually. You go into the menu, you have the menu of BIM in one click, and it allows you to have to do the viaduct and tunnel studies, to link your software of calculation with your 3D production, to do the environmental studies, to have the network deviation studies, all federated with the help of BIM in one click. These tools have been developed by Systra because simply we were fed up to do the abortive work and the rework due to modification and so on and so far. So we have developed this tool in order to give a better day-to-day work to our engineers and CAD operator. So how BIM in one click is working? You have your alignment of metro, you have the location of your pier on the line with the chain age, and you can model, even if it's tunnel or viaduct, with the object library directly your pier layout and your tunnel in 3D. And you can inject also the data in it with the Excel sheet. So you can see here the example of the viaduct and the tunnel. And from these models, you can, of course, extract the drawing production, the 2D drawings. You can do your quantity takeoff, your excavation management for the tunnels. You can export in IFC, meaning that you have an interoperability with all the softwares, and more. And I will show you what we are doing for viaduct. will talk about another innovation for Systra. It's named GeoSystra. It's a database, actually, powered by ArcGIS, hosted by Systra, which is linked to the EDMS, to the CDE, meaning that you can communicate the database with your drawing production, your calculation, your report, and so on. And you can have also access to this database in all the in a web application. Meaning from your smartphone on site, you can have access to the data, and you can also share the data from your mobile when you are doing the borehole, for instance, for the geotech. So this, the advantage of that is that your client can have access with a good rights to the progress of the geotechnical campaign on site. And when, as soon as you have done your borehole, you can directly send this information to the geotechnical engineers in back office to treat the data. So here is some example about what we can do with that. So the first one is the collection of the borehole by the operator on site. So you can submit your borehole, then the engineer receives it. He can open it, and he can use it, store it into the database with the traffic data, the project geolocation, and so on. And he can use it for doing the geotechnical profile directly from this database. So you can see here the how we build the soil layers for based on this borehole. So it is meaning also that each time you are doing a modification, each time you need the data, it's available for everybody. And this data is readable by the softwares, and you can access it very easily. So that is the main innovation of this database. So of course, it's linked with BIM in one click. So when you have generated your tunnel in the longitudinal profile, you can take off the soil's volume with the planning to say to your client, OK, these days you will extract this kind of soil, and the volume will be this. So we have used that for Greater Paris Express. And that was one of the questions this morning. But with GeoSystra, it's a database. We have all the traffic data in it. We can do simulation to find the best path for multimodal network, multimodal transportation system. And we are using that to do it. It has been done recently on our project in Middle East. You can also do the waste tracking management on this application. And you can use it in back office during the design, but also when you are on site to follow up the activities linked to that. So now I want to show you one of the applications behind the 3D models. When you are designing a station, a metro station, where you welcome public and user of the metro, you have some rules to respect in terms of security, in terms of queuing. And with the models, we are using another software to generate this simulation of passenger flows. It allows us to optimize the station layout. So we are talking about sustainability again here. And it also allows us to validate the models that we are providing. To say, OK, at peak hours, we'll wait maybe 2 or 3 minutes. And it's compliant with our requirements. And for in case of accidental event, we are able to manage the evacuation of the station in a very limited time. So with that, we did scenarios, and we test it, and we can present it. It's very, there is no need of explanation. We can explain that to our client for them to understand what is behind the calculation and the design. So in Sistra, we are also doing a lot of buildings. So okay, for metro station, but also all the facilities which are going with. So we are doing the MEP, we are doing the architectures, and this is the example of a station in India. There is a lot of pipes. So here we are building two times the station. One times here. And we solve all the clashes. We solve the interfaces with the structures, with architectures. And then it goes on site. And they build the facilities. We are doing also some planning for you can see here the piers and foundations, so some 4D. And in Sistra India, our core team for station is there in India, so we have more than 200 people working on buildings here. So this is our core area. We are working for railway. This is high speed. And when you are taking the train, you cannot imagine the number of disciplines who has worked together on these models. Here, just to give you an overview, you have the alignment expert, you have the earthwork guy, you have the geotechnical engineers, the power supply engineers, the tunnel engineers, the viaduct engineers, and so on. So we need to federate models to manage the interfaces, to make the collaboration happen, and to deliver a clash-free model to our client. So this is what we are doing, actually, to reduce the risk of the construction. So here you have the example of a very important interface, so a night grade section with a tunnel. And another expertise that we are here in India, specifically in Ahmedabad, it's highways. So why are we doing that? Sometimes it's not needed, it's not claimed by our clients. But when you are doing some large infrastructure like highways of dozens of kilometers, you are changing the neighborhood, you are changing the landscape, and you need to make this project adopted by others. And that's why sometimes, with a small movies like that, you can have the acceptance of the public, of your client, about what you are doing and what you are designing. It's more, I would say, easier to communicate on this kind of materials than on 2D drawings or calculation reports. So, for me, these projects are huge. We are combining a lot of expertise and a lot of engineers from different cultures, from different areas. And when you see the federated model like that at these scales, so it's just rendering, but you can imagine that behind that there is technical models with all the components of the line, we need BIM and the digital to help us to deliver the best of the expertise of our engineers. So for me, that's it. I just want to tell you that we are today recruiting in Sistra to support our growth in Asia and India. So if you need, if you want, if you are passionate, please contact us to send us your CVs. We'll be happy to welcome you into the international team. Thank you.
Thank you, Bruska.